struggling to find an audience, and it's just a fantastic way to bring a new audience to this incredible institution here in Seattle and also symphonies across the country. So.
And vice versa, it's a privilege. That kind of music is a privilege to be involved in. Like, that musicianship sets the bar so high that it's really important that we honor symphonies in our communities.
Yes, they're a really special part of them. Absolutely. Well, I want to talk about this last song. That this song has quite a story. And it was written, the song Hallelujah, many of you know the song that was written by Leonard Cohen, who I think is to Canada what Bob Dylan is to the United States. He's the poet laureate of Canada, and it's just an incredible song that has captured people's affection in a way that almost no other song that I've ever experienced has. It's the kind of song that if you hear it in your car, maybe the first time you ever heard it, you stop and you sit still. And I think it came to a lot of people's attention when the singer-songwriter Jeff Buckley covered it on a live disc, and then many, many artists have since covered it and made it their own. It's just a beautiful song. Talk about what the song means to you.
Well, the song has had such a profound influence on me as a songwriter and as a singer, and then it has had such a spiritual influence on me at the same time. You know, when we did the chart for the song, it was during the time I was feeling a little bit self-conscious about singing this song, like maybe too many people were doing it, or maybe it was uncomfortable for me to continue doing it because it didn't make any sense to put it anywhere in the set list except for at the end. You know, and how many years can you close a show with the same song, you know, without sort of letting down your audience. So these kinds of things were sort of plaguing me. I've since done a 180 about this song and what it means, because I've noticed, and you'll notice there are cover tunes on this record, that my generation of singer-songwriters has become increasingly more and more snooty about covering other people's music. Like they think that art is individual, and it is, and that it should be introspective, and that you should sing your own songs. And there's something to be said for that, and I feel that way a lot of the time, but that's not really, that doesn't really do justice to the way that American music has developed over the years, and American folk stories, and the way that we tell each other stories and the way that we sing each other's songs. It cultivates standards, and that, you know, if our generation isn't careful, that's something that they will sequence out of it, is standards and paying homage to the songwriters that influenced us. So Hallelujah, I think, has penetrated my generation of singer-songwriters armor, and it has influenced so many of us that we all sing it. And even though Leonard Cohen is Canadian, Hallelujah will be a great American and Canadian standard for centuries to come because of the way that it's influenced each other. And when we came up with a chart for this song, I thought maybe this could be the one part of the song that's mine. Nobody has this symphony chart, you know, it's for me.